Hi there, it's Kute here, sending you much love wherever you're watching this short video blog right now. In today's short video blog, I'm going to teach you the four keys to asking for what you want. How do you ask for what you want and increase your chances of getting what you're asking for? You know, when you have a dream or a vision, at some moment you realize you can't do it alone. If you have a dream or a vision and you want to manifest it in the real world, you will have to enlist the support of your friends, your family, your community. If you look at anyone that did anything great, whether it was a Gandhi or Muhammad Ali or Mother Teresa, they had to ask, but they also had to ask in a way that would inspire those around them to support them, to give to them. You know, without asking, if you don't ask, you can't receive. And many times we're too afraid to ask because we're afraid of rejection. We're too afraid to ask because we don't want to impose on someone else. We're too afraid to ask in so many ways. And so we don't ask. If you don't ask, you don't receive. But sometimes when we do actually muster up the courage to ask, we ask in a way that's ineffective. Have you ever asked for something that you thought was a great idea, or you thought was good, or you were passionate about, and you asked and no one responded? The question is, why is that? There's four simple keys that I want you to think about, to understand and consider when it comes to you asking for what you want. So the first key is simply this: get very specific about what you are asking for. Many times we're not exactly clear about our request. We approach someone who's very busy, and because they're successful, we approach them and we say, can you help me? Can I take you to lunch and pick your brain? And this is the last thing a busy person wants to hear because they don't have time. And many times when they say, well, what do you want? We might fluster around and not be quite sure about exactly articulating what we really want. So number one, get clear and specific and be able to clearly articulate your want, your need, your desire in one or two sentences. Make it understandable, make it easy so that the person on the receiving end of your request will get it and understand you in one sentence. I would like this specific thing, and make sure it's tangible and trackable so you know exactly what they're asking for, and you know when it will be fulfilled. So be specific. Number two, get clear on your motivation. Get clear on why you want this. Get clear on why you're asking. Get clear on what's driving you. There's times that, you know, we ask for things and we're not really in alignment with what we're asking for. It's maybe we're going in a direction that we think we should, or we're requesting something that we think we should have. And so when your request is not in alignment with your deeper, authentic motivation, your energy will not be powerful. Your energy will not be clear. And so really tune into your heart. Center yourself in yourself. Connect to your spirit. Take time, you know, out of your mind to breathe, to listen, to meditate, and get clear on why you are doing what you are doing, why you want what you want, the greater impact, the why, and make sure your reason for what you want is authentic. If you're making this request because society thinks you should have it or do it, or simply because your family thinks that's what's best for you, it won't be in alignment, and that misalignment inside of yourself will be felt, will be energetically felt, and you won't have the true authentic belief within yourself, the belief in what you're asking for. Basically, you'll be out of integrity. Your out of integrity will be felt by the person on the receiving end of your request. To truly enroll someone into your idea or your vision, a key factor is your belief. And your belief is an energy. Belief is a transmission. Belief is a frequency that people can feel when you truly, authentically believe in something, a product, an idea, your request, when they can feel your belief and your motivation, there's a connection. So get clear on your motivation and make sure your motivation is authentic. Number three, here is where a lot of folks make mistakes in asking. Many times people will just ask, hey, can you give me something? And you know, it's kind of like we beg, we ask for something. We sometimes go to people like seeking a handout. I always say this, if you want to increase your chances of having your request fulfilled, it's really important that you don't just go as a beggar. It's really important that you seek to think about how you can also add some value to be of some kind of service to the person you're making the request for. Chances are the person you're making a request of might be a busy person, or they're more successful than you in some way, which is why you're going to them for help, for advice, for support, for mentorship, for money, for whatever it might be. You're approaching them because they have something that you would either like to have, or they're further along, whatever it is. I always say, don't seek to take from people, seek to add from some. Seek to add to people. And even if you don't think you have huge amounts of resources, take inventory of yourself and ask yourself, what do I have? What are my gifts? What can I bring? And how can I actually add value? How can I add value to the person's life that I am making a request of? Many times, successful people are, you know, successful folks around the world are not only busy, but people are always wanting and asking for things from them, to have lunch, for money, for advice, whatever it is. So be someone different. Be someone that stands out. Be someone that is a blessing and a contribution, so that when you go, you have thought out, okay, I'm going to make this request of Joe or Susie or whoever. What do they need? How can I bring something to them as well as ask them for something? It becomes then an energetic exchange. It becomes an energetic exchange. And that energetic exchange feels good to you, but also feels good to them. You're no longer taking from them. You're also gifting to them. And you're giving them an opportunity to receive from you as well. Lastly, when you ask, let go of attachment. When you ask, drop attachment, drop expectation. Many times when we ask, we get really attached to receiving from a specific person. We get really attached to receiving in that specific way. I say, look, drop it completely. Your job is to stand up, be bold, step up, and ask. This is your job. And let go of attachment. What that means is you don't know if... See, when you get so attached to your request being fulfilled by only that one person, you limit the magnificence and the intelligence and the full capacity of the universe's ability to manifest itself in infinite variety of ways. We live in an abundant universe. That person or those group of people are not your source. You've been given a dream, vision, or idea for a reason. So your job is to stay in alignment, stay true, stay in integrity, and stay obedient to your heart's calling. If your dream and vision or that request isn't fulfilled by that person, that doesn't mean it won't be fulfilled. They are not your source. Life is your source. When you ask, you open yourself to actually receiving. And if it's not from that person, that's what I'm saying, don't be attached. If it's not from that person, in your asking, you open yourself. In that openness, then you're available to receiving from wherever it needs to be. Your job is just to ask. So don't get attached to it being that person, because maybe you're closing yourself off to the five other people, the five other opportunities, the 10 other ways that your blessing, that your request can be fulfilled. And also, don't get attached to that specific request being fulfilled as that specific request. Perhaps What you think you want isn't even what you really want. It's just what you think you want in this current moment based on your level of consciousness. Perhaps the universe has something bigger in store. So don't even get attached to your specific request. Stay open and available. Stay open to the highest good. Drop expectation. Be open. Stay open to the highest good and allow. Simply give space to trust and allow the universe and the intelligent universe to fulfill itself through, in, and as you. Folks, there's four simple keys that you can practice right now to increase your chances of having your requests fulfilled, your needs fulfilled. I hope you enjoyed this short video blog. Please do write me, let me know what you received from this video blog. Make sure you are subscribed to my email list, www.kuteblackson.com. Go there, subscribe, connect with me on social media, Instagram, Facebook. Love now.